Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Jesus, we praise you. Jesus, we glorify you. Jesus, we adore you. Just pause for a moment. Close our eyes. Let's feel the presence of the Holy Spirit. Our Holy Spirit, fill us. Fill the hearts of everyone who is participating in this service. They have come with so much sorrows and so much pain. Many of them are so much worried about their future. Our Holy Spirit, increase our faith. We need your help. As Jesus said, we can do nothing apart from me. And we do believe. We are very weak. We are unable to do anything without you. Our Holy Spirit, you are the helper. You are the one who protects us. You are the one who sustains us. You are the one who comforts us. And you are the helper. And today, as we listen to this word of God and adoration, let our hearts be free. Let us become more and more dependent to Jesus. Mother Mary, be with us, guide us, and help us. Let's invoke her intercession by reciting, Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed are thou among us women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Dear brothers and sisters, today, I have seen so many people coming to me and asking the intercession of Mother Mary and all other saints in their lives because they do not get enough blessings from above. They run after retreats. They go after very many people in order to receive the blessings from God. And many think that God is just blind towards their needs. Even some used to think and say that God is showing partiality. He blesses only some people. He doesn't listen to our prayers. And God doesn't intervene in my sufferings, in my problems. And these are the complaints of very many people today. And dear brothers and sisters, we should understand why God is silent in our matters. Why doesn't He give answer to our questions? According to the Word of God, there are certain reasons behind that. If your family is not blessed, if your children is not blessed, if you yourself is not blessed, there are certain reasons behind that. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
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 Dear brothers and sisters, I tell you one incident. One day a man came to me and said he has got so much of business. But he said, I have no financial growth. Financially always I am going down and down. I have a lot of debts. But from morning till evening I do hard work. I don't spend unnecessarily any penny. But I don't have any financial growth. And I was just praying for him. And while praying, I understood one thing. I asked him, do you go to the gambling clubs? He says, yes, I do. And I asked him, how do you spend your money in this? Do you spend money in this activity? He said, Father, I have spent lakhs and lakhs of rupees. I spend a lot of money in this. And once it is lost, then I want to gain it back. Then again, I borrow money and go. Father, it is only because I want to just finish off my debts. And once my debts are off, I won't go for anymore. But in order to finish the debts, in order to solve the problems, I'm going. I said, dear friend, this is your problem. You depend more on your intelligence. You depend more on your abilities. And that is the reason you run after your own thoughts. But do you know that this gambling is something that is an abomination to God? This is something which He doesn't like. And dear brothers and sisters, in our lives, if there are certain things which God doesn't like in our lives, in our families, then absolutely God is not going to bless you. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
This is not my words. This is what the Word of God says. We have got a beautiful example in the book of Joshua. Let's come to the book of Joshua. Joshua was entrusted to lead the people of Israel to the promised land. And while he was leading them, they reached the town of Jericho. We know the story. And there was a very big wall around this Jericho town. And it was only through the might of God they conquered the town of Jericho. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
And not by bloodshed, by the mighty hands of Jesus, by the mighty hand of God, they conquered the town of Jericho. After having conquered this town of Jericho, he wanted to conquer another town called Ai. It is a very small town. It is very close to that. And you know what happened? Joshua asked God, God, is it, if it is pleasing to you, shall we go and attack Ai? Then God said, okay, fine, you go ahead. Accordingly, Joshua made a plan and he sent some secret agents to the town of Ai to investigate how the strength of their military and where is the power, how much is the strong is their army. So in order to make a secret investigation, he sent a few people to this town of Ai. And these people went there, they just made all the investigations and brought the report saying that Ai town is such a small town. So the big troops of Israel need not go there. Just 2,000 or 3,000 men are enough to conquer Ai. So why should we go all around? All need not go. It is a waste. So accordingly, as the secret agents gave him the report, he sends 3,000 soldiers to this land of Ai. Then they started the war. And surprisingly, you know what happened? Though the town of Ai was very small, the Ai people, they attacked and they made a big massacre of the Israelites. And the Israel troops had to flee from there. And they chased them out of their land, and 36 of them were killed on the spot, and so many things happened in the Israel troops, and they had to flee from the small town of Ai. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
So Joshua was very much upset. Then what he did, he tore his garments. He put ashes on his body and he was just prostrating before the Lord and saying, Lord, why did you do this? Why did you do this to the people? We had asked you and with your permission only we went for the war, and why you have done it? And he and the high priest were praying and praying. And finally, we see in the book of Joshua, chapter 7, verse 11, God is giving him the answer. Let us listen to that.
Israel sinned and has violated my covenant.
Israel sinned and has violated my covenant.
Israelites have taken what was set apart by accursed and have hidden stolen objects which their belongings.
The Word of God says, Israel has done something wrong before me. I have said certain things are accursed and you shall not touch. But what they did, they took these accursed things, dishonored things, and kept among their things. And now they have sinned against me. Therefore God of heaven says, they have made a big fault by doing this, by disobeying my commandments. Therefore, unless and until they are sanctified, I cannot bless them. That's what we see in the verse 13.
Go then and sanctify people. Say to them, cleanse yourself for tomorrow. Yahweh, the God of Israel, says to you, O Israel, the accursed is in your midst, and you shall not face your enemies until you have removed the accursed from you.
Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. There are certain indecent things in your camp, in your family, and therefore the word of God says, unless and until you sanctify yourself, you sanctify your family, sanctify your body, I cannot bless you. You cannot face your enemies. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah. Dear brothers and sisters, so if your family is not blessed, we should go to the root. Where is it? Why God is not intervening in my family? Is there certain things which are accursed, which God doesn't want to keep in your house? Maybe a bad habit, maybe a wrong thing which you are doing. You know, the story of Zacchaeus was not blessed because there was an accursed wealth. He just took away from money from many people, and this money was with him, and this money was a hindrance to be blessed by God. And when he was ready to repay what he had taken from people, God said, today your family is saved. And everyone should make a introspection of yourself. What are the things in your family that prevents God to bless you? And in the confessional, you have to say all this and make a perfect confession. Yeah, you know one thing, dear brothers and sisters, when many people come and say, we have not that, got this, we are not that, we have blocks, this and that, I used to tell them, go and make a very good confession. Let your family members make a very good confession. Then be sure you are going to be blessed. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. So too, dear brothers and sisters, the word of God says, unless and until you are sanctified, your family is not sanctified, you cannot face your enemies. The enemies can be of different sorts. Maybe financial crisis, or maybe some other blocks in your life, job problems, or maybe some delay in marriage, whatever may be, these are to be removed. Praise the Lord.
Praise the
Hallelujah.
Lord. Hallelujah.
Again, the book of Deuteronomy, chapter 23, verse 14. The book of Deuteronomy 23:14, word of God says in this way,
because the Lord your God travels along with your camp to save you and to hand over the enemies to you, therefore your camp must be hollow, so that he may not see anything indecent among you and turn away from you.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
The word of God says, see, God is going to travel through, or he is going to visit your camp in order to hand over the enemies to your hands and in order to bless you. God is going to travel over your camps, and if there is something indecent, God may turn away and go back. He will not bless you. Therefore, make sure that you clean up your camps. And that is what word of God says. Dear brothers and sisters, what do you mean by camp? There are two camps. The first camp is your family itself. This is a camp where Jesus visits, where God visits. And when he comes, and if he finds that there are something which is not decent, which are accursed, which God does not want, certain activities in your life, maybe some sinful tendencies in your family, maybe getting together and doing a fight against your somebody, your brothers or sisters, whatever may be, there are certain things which God doesn't consider holy. And if things are there, he cannot bless you unless and until you remove them. You cannot get blessed. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
There is another camp, it's called the body. Your body is a camp. And if there is something that is indecent in this body, God cannot bless you. God cannot give you blessings. He cannot answer to your prayers. I have seen so many people, when they have stopped doing wrong things in their body, maybe for the physical satisfaction, maybe people something wrong on their body, you know, to please their body. And when they have stopped doing this habitual thing or bad habits, I have seen God blessing so many people. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
So make sure that your body is pure. And once your body is pure, your camp is fine. Because this is a camp where the Holy Spirit lives. And in a camp, in a body where unholy things happens, the Holy Spirit cannot stay, and such persons cannot be blessed. Dear brothers and sisters, as we meditate on this topic, let us ask the Lord to show us what are the things that are unholy in our life. What are the areas where we make ourselves unworthy to receive God's graces? Is there anything abomination, or is there anything indecent in my family, in my body? Therefore, let's ask the Lord. And if there is something there, sanctify yourself. You make a good confession. Ask the Lord, Lord, this is my situation. I need your grace. And personally, make a decision to remove what is accursed, which is indecent. Then God is going to bless you and your family. Let's stand up. Let's surrender ourselves totally and fully to God. Raise the hands up to heaven. Let's thank and worship the Lord. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Oh Lord, we praise and thank you, Lord. Oh Lord, we bless you for this day. Oh Lord, we thank you, Lord, for all the blessings that you give to us. Oh Lord, help us to sanctify ourselves so that let all the blocks to receive the blessing from God be gone from my family and from my body. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Let the precious blood of Jesus wash over them. Lord, sanctify.
Cleanse my body, mind and soul.
Oh Holy Spirit,
purify me and make me whole. Sanctify me, oh God. Cleanse my body, mind and soul.
Jesus,
purify me and make me whole. Sanctify me, oh God. Cleanse my body, mind and soul. Purify me and make me whole.
Oh Holy Spirit, help us to sanctify ourselves. Help us to remove the accursed things in our lives, in our families, wherever we are, so that we may be blessed more and more. We may receive blessings from above in abundance. Jesus, help us. Amen. Amen. Let's praise and worship the Lord. Our mighty God is here with us. Hallelujah. Raising the hands up to heaven. Let's praise and thank the Lord. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Lord, we praise and thank you. Lord, we need your blessings in abundance. We need your courage and strength. We need your deliverance in our lives. In the name of Jesus, let there all the chains be broken down. Let all the powers of darkness be gone in Jesus' name. Let us pray in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, there is power.
In the name of Jesus, there is power. In the name of
Jesus, there is deliverance, there is healing, there is power.
There is power in the name of Jesus to break every chain.
Let every chain be broken down in Jesus' name.
To break
let the power of Jesus come down to each and everyone who is watching
to break
this
chain,
service.
To
oh Lord, all those who are attending in their own homes, in their own offices, may they be blessed in Jesus'
there
name. And all the blessings be God in Jesus' name.
In the name of Jesus, there is power in the name of Jesus.
In Jesus' name, let all the blocks,
there is
all the problems, all the sickness be cured
in the name of Jesus.
Lord, let the grace come down.
To
let the anointing increase. Or let be judged by the Holy Spirit.
To break every
hallelujah.
To break every chain.
Hallelujah. Let there be a mighty healing in Jesus' name. Let there be a great anointing in Jesus' name.
Let
everyone be filled with the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. In Jesus' name, let us deliver in Jesus' name. Let all the chains be broken down. Hallelujah, hallelujah,
hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
Let's bow our hearts. Oh, sacrament.
Blessed be God.
Blessed be his holy name. Blessed be Jesus Christ, true God and true man. Blessed be the name of Jesus. Blessed be his most sacred heart. Blessed be his most precious blood. Blessed be Jesus in the most holy sacrament of the altar. Blessed be the Holy Spirit, the Paraclete. Blessed be the great Mother of God, Mary most holy. Blessed be her holy and immaculate conception. Blessed be her glorious assumption. Blessed be the name of Mary, Virgin and Mother. Blessed be Saint Joseph, her most chaste spouse. Blessed be God and his angels and in his saints. Amen.